Dear students, good morning. It's second part of phrases, clauses and sentences. And the exercise given here in front of you is exercise 1 and exercise 2. As you can see, the exercise 1, in this exercise, you have to separate which is phrase and which is clause. So, number 1, in exercise 1, number 1, down the road. So, this is phrase because phrase doesn't contain its subject and predicate, and the clause contains its subject and predicate. So in this way you can separate the phrase and clause. As you can see here, down the road. So that is phrase because in this sentence there is no subject and predicate. A solemn leg. That is also phrase because in this sentence also there is no subject and predicate. Although they were late. So that is the clause because in this sentence they were late. So there is the subject and that is the verb and then object that is clause. In the fourth sentence, between the lake and the forest. So that is also phrase because in this sentence also there is no subject and predicate. When the rain begins, that is clause because the rain begins. So in this sentence there is subject and predicate and verb of its own. So that is why it is clause. Sixth number, the funny monkey. That is phrase because in this sentence there is no subject and predicate of its own. So that is a phrase. Seventh number, because it looks pretty. It is a clause because it has its own subject and verb. And number 8, in the garden. That is phrase because in this sentence there is no subject and predicate of its own. You can see the exercise 2. In this, you have to find out which kind of sentence is that. So, I told you in the last video lecture, different kinds of sentences and their example also. So, different kinds of sentences are given here. And just after the sentence, you have to put the marks according to the sentence. If that is a simple sentence, you have to put full stop. If that is interrogative sentence, you have to put question mark. If that is exclamatory sentence, you have to put exclamation mark like that. So you can see number 1, open the door at page, open the book at page 24. So that is the imperative sentence, that is command. So in the last of the sentence, in imperative sentences we apply full stop, that is applied here. In the next sentence, how hot it is. So that is the exclamatory sentence. So in the last of the sentence, that is exclamatory mark is applied here. You can see in the third sentence, have you ever heard about Kumbhakarna? So that is the interrogative sentence or question sentence. And in the last of the sentence, you can see the question mark is here. Fourth sentence, turn the TV down. So that is the imperative sentence, that is command. So in the last of the sentence, full stop is applied here. And what channel is the program on? So that is the interrogative or question sentence. And in the last of the interrogative sentence, we apply question mark here. And number 6, the moon goes round the earth. So that is the simple sentence or declarative. And as I told you, declarative sentence is divided into two parts, positive and negative. So that is a positive sentence. The moon goes round the earth, that is the simple sentence. So full stop is applied there. And seventh number, what a lovely garden. So that is the exclamatory sentence. And in the last of the sentence, exclamatory mark is applied here. Read the instructions carefully. So that is also command, that is imperative sentence. And in imperative sentences, we apply full stop. So that is applied there. Can you lend me your DVD player? So that is interrogative sentence. That begins with can model. So that is interrogative sentence. In question mark is applied there in the last of the sentence. I got the information from the internet. So that is also simple sentence. And in simple sentences, generally we apply full stop. So in the last of the sentence, full stop is applied there. And there is a phone message for you. So that is is also a simple sentence. So in this, in the last of the sentence, full stop is applied. In the last 12th number, how useful the computer is. So that is the exclamatory sentence, and exclamation mark is applied in the last of the sentence. So now next week we will see exercise 3 and exercise 4. Dear students, in exercise 3 and 4 you have to do. In exercise 3 you have to make the questions of these sentences, simple sentences. And one more thing you have to keep in mind. If your sentence belong to present tense, you will make the question in present tense. If your sentence belong to past tense, you will make the question in past tense. If your sentence belong to future tense, you will make the question in future. So for your first sentence, I live in Raipur. So the question will be, where do you live? And then question mark. Your next sentence, I will meet you soon. So when will you meet? And then third number, I bought a gift for my brother. The question will be, what did you buy for your brother? And then in the last question mark. Then fourth number, the dog broke the vase on the side table. And then your question will be, who broke the vase on the side table? And then in the last you will put the question mark. And fifth number, my name is Sudhanshu. So the question will be, what is your name? In the sixth number, I studied in Paris. So your question will be, where did you study? And in exercise 4, in this exercise, you have to make question tail of these sentences. But one thing you have to keep in mind, that if your sentence is in negative, you will make the positive question tail. And if your sentence is in positive, you will make the negative question tail. First of all, you have to find out the helping verb and then subject to make the question tail. If your sentence is in negative, if your sentence is positive, first of all you will find the helping verb and then not, because positive sentences, we will need the negative question tag, so helping verb, and then not, and then subject. Like this you will make the question tag. So first sentence, it is not raining. The question tag will be, is it, and then question mark. Second number, Mira was laughing. So then was not see, wasn't see, or was not see. And then third number, they will go to the park. The question tag will be, will not they, or won't they? Then question mark. In the fourth sentence, he is very friendly. Isn't he? Is not he, or isn't he? Then we cannot go to the movies. Then your sentence is in negative. Then you will make the positive question tag. Then sixth number, she is not scared of the dog. Then the question tag will be, is she? Because that is negative sentence. I am a smart girl. So the question tag will be, am not I, or ain't I? Then the last one is, you are not a lazy boy. Your sentence is negative. So you will make positive question tag. Then are you? Like that you will make question tag. Thank you.